Bonjour, bonjour. Today, I'd like to share what la galette des rois is, what we're pretty much celebrating in France when we buy one, eat one, and some of the history behind it. And you're gonna explore with us. Join us. Maybe you can go to a local French bakery and ask for une galette des rois. Hi, my name is Rochelle DeMeo from Belterre Academy. So usually on January 6th, or technically all throughout January, but January 6th is the day that it's usually celebrated, we celebrate by eating this traditional cake called galette des rois, made with simple ingredients, flour, whatnot. There's technically two variants of galette des rois. The first one's more of like a brioche with fruit on it, whatnot, and it kind of looks kind of like a crown already. And the second one looks definitely more of like a cake, and it has like marzipan in it, and it's frangipane. So those are kind of the two variants of la galette des rois that exist. And the way that it works is everybody, either in your family or group, you know, you could be with a group of friends, you could be with family members, everybody's gonna get a slice of this galette des rois. And one of the slices, we don't know which one, has this little fève. A fève is a little figurine. Usually it's made out of porcelain. Sometimes they make them out of other stuff, depending, but usually it's, the traditional ones are made out of porcelain, and whoever gets that fève, so that little figurine, and it could represent different things, whatever it is the king or the queen for that year or that day. You know, I forget how they word it, but pretty much, they're the king or they're the queen. I'm gonna give them a call and see if I can order. I'm gonna see what I'm gonna order. I'm gonna order more than just the galette des rois. Anyway, this could be a little guide for you so that you can also order from a local French bakery, experience it with us maybe. You can even pause the video and eat it with us as you're watching the video, and you'll know what to say. Oui, bonjour. Oui, je voudrais passer une petite commande, s'il vous plaît. Oui, super, merci. Alors, j'aimerais commander, s'il vous plaît, une galette des rois. Brioche ou frangipane? Frangipane, s'il vous plaît. Oui. Et avec ceci, je vais vous prendre une baguette aux olives, si vous avez. Voilà. Oui, si vous pouvez au moins le réserver. D'accord, est-ce que je pourrais en fait venir la chercher demain? Ah ben c'est encore mieux. À 13h, est-ce que ça vous irait? D'accord. Alors, oui, nom de famille. Donc, Madame DeMeo. D-E-M-E-O. Oui, numéro de téléphone. Alors, le 06 98 11 73 20. Exactement. Oui, 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 oui. D'accord. Ben merci, je vous remercie. À demain. Bonne journée à vous aussi. Ok, il est temps de chercher la galette. Let's go get the galette.
Bonjour.
Bonjour, comment allez-vous?
Bien, et vous?
Merci.
Ah, la famille va bien?
Tout va bien, oui.
Ah, super, ici pareil. Ben, je viens récupérer la commande, du coup.
Oui, alors la galette. Alors, nous avons une galette à la frangipane.
Super.
Avec la fève et la couronne.
Ouh là là.
Et une baguette aux olives.
Ah super. Merci, ça a l'air tellement bon.
Pas de problème. Il vous faut autre chose pour aujourd'hui?
Non, c'est tout. Je pense que je vais faire on va faire ça en goûter aujourd'hui. Galette des rois en goûter. Et ce soir, je pensais faire une soupe italienne, une minestrone. Et avec
la baguette.
Sera, voilà, exactement. Pain aux olives.
Les enfants, on va y gâter aujourd'hui.
Ouh oui. Combien je vous dois?
Alors, la galette c'est 320 et la baguette c'est 350, donc ça fait un total de 16,79.
D'accord.
Merci. Carte de crédit.
Oui.
Ouais. Vous avez besoin d'un reçu?
Non, ça va. Merci beaucoup.
De rien, et voilà, et bonne journée.
Merci, bonne journée à vous.
Alors, Gianni qui est dessous, comme la tradition le demande, eh bien, le plus petit, sous la table, qui va appeler les noms pour la galette des rois.
Et Jenny, qui mange
Clémentine. That's what tradition requires. The youngest goes on the table and he calls the names. It's whoever the youngest is. Then they get this little crown that they wear. Now it's made out of paper, whatever it is. And then they would designate you know, their queen if they're a king, or their king if they're a queen. So that's usually how it works. And but there are a few rules that you might want to know if you decide to go out, find a local French bakery, ask for a galette-des-rois. First thing is that's good to know is, like, usually the youngest person in that group, the group that you're going to be eating the galette-des-rois with, is going to go underneath the table. And they will call out without seeing who gets which slice of cake.
Jenny, premier nom.
Andrew.
Okay.
They may just call out different names, and then that's kind of who picks which, who gets what. And then that's how they'll find out if they got the fèvre, that little figurine, or not.
Après qui, Jenny?
Moi.
Okay. Après?
Noah.
Ok, prends ça. Après?
Ça va.
Vas-y. Et après, t'entends.
Moi j'ai le plus petit morceau. Oh, regarde, moi j'ai le plus petit morceau.
Ok, bah, on va voir qui est le roi ou la reine.
And then actually the real tradition is when you're eating the galette des rois, you would drink cider with it. Des Rois is really the cake of kings. It commemorates the three wise men.
Yep. Yeah.
Oh. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Il est le roi. Il est le roi de la jungle. Il est le roi de la mer. Surf's up, dude. Il est le roi de tout l'univers.
And so that's why we celebrate it after Christmas, because usually from the history that we know and whatnot, the wise men, even if we see in the manger, we see all the little, you know, we see a creche in the little manger that we usually display for Christmas, we see the wise men that were there. Well, history actually is teaching us that the day Jesus was born is when they saw the star and then they went to see him. We don't know exactly when in the year that was, although people do believe that it could have been the 6th of January that the wise men actually went and gave their different gifts to baby Jesus. Now this tradition evolved over time because the Romans actually started kind of celebrating that day, and they would have a slave that would be the king for the day. So they actually called this festivity Les Saturnales, and it was actually to celebrate a god, Saturn. And they had this little fève, so this little like fève that they would have then put in the cake. That's where it started from. But it wasn't made out of porcelain or plastic like it is now. Eating the cake was kind of to honor the three wise men in their journey. If you're figuring out, like, how would you eat it, well, you can obviously see from our little video and our experience how we're celebrating. But you really, it's, they say it's advisable or advised to warm it up a little bit beforehand if you can. Now, who invented this frangipane, so this marzipan taste? They say that supposedly his name was Matteo Frangipani, probably an Italian. But during the reign of Louis XIII, he would have put this flavor in the cake to mask the odor of, like, different disgusting shoes that people used to wear at the time. That's what history is telling us. So now we do have that little figurine, but back in the day, the more rich families would put, like, a little coin in there, and poor families would just put a bean. So what do you think? Hopefully this video was informative. You learned some stuff about the history. You learned how to order at a French bakery, and hopefully you're able to taste the galette des rois and enjoy it because it's so good. A bientôt!